All right, I know what you're going to say. The tax returns are out, not the president, so we can't comment on how much he did or didn't give to charity over the years. We only can go on the ones we do see released, including from this crop of candidates who are now maybe making you wonder, do as I say, not as I donate. Some of them running for president, arguing that the government needs to be a lot more charitable when it comes to their own tax returns. Do they practice what they preach? It depends on the year you're talking about. In Beto O'Rourke's case, not quite. He talks about sacrificing for a Green New Deal, but has, in the best of years, given over about 2% of his income to charity, and that was during a generous year. How much has he been sacrificing? He is just one of many returns that we're analyzing, not for the fact that they all seem to be making a lot of money, and they all seem to be at least in the top 5% of the population. But Hillary Vaughn has gone beyond that to see how much they give away in the process. Hey, Hillary.
Hey, Neil. Well, 2020 Democrats have criticized the wealthy, calling them kings and queens and criticizing Republicans over tax cuts. But it turns out when it comes to their own cash, they have a pretty tight grip. Democrats running for president are below average in charitable giving compared to American taxpayers in the same tax bracket. In 2017, Beto O'Rourke gave just over $1,000 to charity, 0.3% of his income. But IRS data says people in his tax bracket gave about 20 times more than that. Just moments ago at a house party in Virginia, O'Rourke defended his charitable giving, saying not everything shows up on his tax returns, and he also addressed this last night.
There are ways that I do this that are measurable, and there are ways that I do this that are measurable. There are charities that we donate to that we've recorded and itemized, others that we've donated to that we have not.
Senator Bernie Sanders, who's led his campaign against millionaires and billionaires, is a millionaire himself and not as open to sharing the wealth, giving almost $19,000 of his 2018 earnings, 3.4% of his income. Compare that to average Americans earning the same, who gave over 5% to charity. Senator Kamala Harris gave absolutely nothing to charity during her first 3 years she served as California's attorney general. In 2017, she gave less than 1.5% away. It turns out the most generous top-tier presidential candidate on the left is Senator Elizabeth Warren, who gave almost 6% of her paycheck to charity in 2017. Compare that to former presidential candidates before they made it to the White House. Former President Barack Obama in 2007 gave 5.7% of his income away. Former President George W. Bush offered up 16% of his pay in 1999. And in 1991, former President Bill Clinton giving over 6% of his income to charity. Now, Neil, President Trump has given gifts to charity, saying he's donated over $100 million in gifts to different organizations in the first 5 years leading up to his 2016 presidential run. And he also gives 100% of his presidential paycheck, all $400,000, to different agencies in the U.S. government. And when Senator Bernie Sanders was asked at our Fox News town hall if he would donate more of his money to the government as a way to back up his campaign pledge to raise taxes on millionaires, he laughed. Neil?
Okay. Hillary Vaughn, thank you very, very much. Again, we do not have the president's taxes to know what he is donating himself right now. We do know that he foregoes his entire presidential salary, $400,000 a year, and gives that to charity. Also, we do know that Ronald Reagan, famous for saying he feels it's an obligation to do the Christian and the good thing, to tithe, to give 10% of what you make. But his average during the 1980s was around 3.6% at its high point in 1983. 2% in 1982, about 2.8%. Ronald Reagan had said at the time that a good deal of that money was not marked for a charitable donation, and he would separately release the names of charities to which he did give money that were not on those tax returns. So you can get lost in the weeds on this stuff, but fair and balanced. They generally do a little bit less than tithing. Democratic strategist David Burstein joins us, Melissa Armo of Stock Swoosh fame, and Republican strategist Noel Nickpour. So, David, the immediate rap you're going to get from Republicans on this, conservatives, oh, you Democrats talk a big game about how we should have more of a government to help folks, but you don't do it yourself.
Well, I think the point there is that how much money people are giving to charity, we're talking about relatively small distinctions here. The reason people suggest there should be a different tax rate is that these private charities don't actually, they're designed to fill holes. They're not designed to solve the problem.
Look, government the thing, because to, these guys aren't right? giving it to them.
Well, government needs to step up to the plate. And so if all the people and the people who have billions
but if you really
and millions
believe in
of dollars,
this sort of stuff and you're preaching, you should help your fellow man.
But these are people who are in pocket, right? Public service. They have dedicated their lives to trying to help people and make the world a better place. And I think
half of them are millionaires.
Yeah,
right?
but they're giving money. I mean, they don't have the ability. Another $4,000 or $3,000. I've run nonprofits myself, so right. I understand this stuff. Is not going to make the difference between the.
Well,
ability
it might
to do
not, but again,
not.
It's consistency. And again, Republicans have been criticized on this subject. Well, but to be fair, they don't go around advocating big government, even though big government has gotten bigger under their rule. I'm just wondering, Melissa, whether, these guys got to practice what they preach, all of them.
I do. If you're going to talk the talk, you got to walk the walk. And the thing is that, Elizabeth Warren, she came out, she gave the most. She's going to milk this for all it's worth. How about it? I bet she will. But I will say one thing. If people are going to fight against this Republicans, they need a stronger message, because this socialist message, give, 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 and big government, is taking over. And that is a problem. It's a problem if, say, Trump wins in 2020. It's a problem then in the next presidential election, because people, regular people, believe that the rich should pay more, whether it's to charities, whether it's on their taxes. People that need help, people that aren't making $300,000 a year, feel that people should give more. And I think the Republicans got to get behind and have a stronger message to combat this, or the government's going to completely take control of everything.
By the way,
we're going to have a 70%
tax rate. These are extreme years when they have a book out or they've had a very good time on the speaking circuit. They will give more of a dollar amount, but in percentage terms, it's not as much in a percentage amount. And you've heard the Ronald Reagan tithing thing, but he didn't tithe, right?
No, but one of the things that if I were a strategist on the D side, if I were advising some of these candidates once they're hit with this, one of the things that I would have looked at and said, I would have been like, depending on what they gave politically, I would have been like, I may not have been charitable, but I'm trying to help with my message by supporting XYZ candidates. It's not tax deductible, but I believe in the cause and I believe in, being a Democrat and being a liberal, whatever. So I've given to A, B, C, D, E, F, G candidates. So I am still.
Well, that was the Ronald Reagan you would give. And others who've been very generous with their money, but they didn't get the tax write-off. I think quite a few billionaires have done that. But I'm just wondering where it slips up on them. If you're making this a cause, you have to be really vigilant about making it show up on your tax return.
But this isn't the cause. They're not saying everybody needs to donate more money to charity. They think the government needs to be better resource.
Especially those in their league, we all have to pony up more to the government.
But that's a different point than the question of how much money they give to charity.
But the Democrats make the Republicans feel like we're greedy, greedy capitalist pigs, while they are the more touchy-feely help a brother in need kind of party. And it's very interesting to see that some of these candidates who are preaching that message are not.
But they want others to pay money, right? And they want others to fork up. So whether it's the top 1%, 5%, whatever, well, they're in that group and they're not doing it.
Well, you know what? If Trump did pay what he said he did to charities or donated or whatever, even if he showed his tax returns, they'd still criticize him. They'd still have negative things to say. Wouldn't even matter. They would still criticize
him. Well, let's say he's a billionaire and we take it as word that he is, and he gives, let's say, $100 million away, and it's a fraction of that. It's all.
They still hate his guts.
Would you call him a hypocrite in that?
No, way? I'm not going to call anyone a hypocrite at all. No,
okay.
If somebody makes $300,000 a year and they give 1% to charity, in fact, if someone gives anything to charity, I said, good for you.
Right.
Congratulations.
Because
you could have stuffed that money under the mattress yourself.
Absolutely. Yeah. You could have done that.
Help somebody.
And joined a Tibetan monkhood. guys, I want to thank you very, very much. In the meantime, the Polish prime minister is here in the flesh. He's visiting the United States. But he's making a push on Europe and this European Union, making a statement. It's not just Britain that has a problem with that club. So does he. Next.